conclusion of our Nevertomes presentation. Last episode of the Nevertomes, the split in the timeline between the Dick Tracy universe and the Jones universe was explained, and how Angelica Jones herself was the epicenter of the temporal divergence. Surrendering to the police after setting her famous fedora-wearing captive free, Angelica and her future husband, the Son of the Brow, were given a plea bargain for psychiatric commitment at St. Vincent's Sanitarium in central Missouri, as a result of their cooperative behavior and remorse. Following their release after 2 years, Angel Top's emotional meeting with her first cousins Susan, Rebecca, Randy, Esther, and their children sent Angelica on a quest to find both her 3-year-old son Harold, whom she had abandoned prior to the malice expulsion spell that was cast on her, and traveling to Europe to reunite with her African-American biological mother Stiletta Jones. After a tearful reunion in Europe, both mother and daughter traveled to a cafe in the next town, where after more than 30 years, Stiletta Jones finally came face to face with the sister-in-law that was entrusted with the care of her late son, Flat Top Jr., as we continue with the conclusion of the Lost Jones Files on the Nevertomes. Anita was blanched with fright. She feared her sister-in-law would go for her throat for how Junior could not be controlled, and that his death was somehow her fault. However, both women admitted that they shared the blame, but decided that Junior chose his own path and was not a reflection of them. They would still miss him and they would still mourn him, but he created his own destiny. While Stiletta was still contractually bound to the circus for another year, she swore to Angelica that she would come back to the States and retire from the circus for good. It was around the time that they came back from Denmark that Robert and the caseworker tracked down Angelica's son and a good lawyer. Angelica wrote letters to her little boy, who was apparently 3 years old at this time. She referred to him as her little Herschel, the Yiddish equivalent of Harold, since Maddie and her children were Jewish. This was brought up a lot in conversation during her stay. Not long after they came back to the States, Anita sadly grew sicker and passed away at a young age, comforted by the fact that she had finally made peace with all of her family. This hit Angelica hard, since her love for her aunt blossomed back after confronting demons from her past under Anita's care, as chronicled in the mythos story, Angels and Flames. Harold Jones in the Dick Tracy comic was the product of an affair between Angel Top and an unnamed African-American jazz musician, who many believe Angelica killed. As it turns out, the results of Nicole's malice expulsion wave had consequences that went backwards in time as well, creating dimensional distortions both before and after the fact. In this instance, the father was believed to have died at a different point in time, either by an accidental drug overdose, a car accident, or foul play with another lover. It was also quite possible that the man who was killed in these events was a different person altogether. The Brotherhood of Pans has been unable to confirm or deny any of this in their research. Harold's parentage is still canon, but thanks to the caseworker assigned to Harold and Angelica's case, the little boy was reunited with his mother, although since her appearance was starkly different from the pictures of her he had, he was initially confused, but happily returned to her. Harold got to meet the new father in his life as well, the one who would adopt him as his own, and not just be a stepfather, Richard Dubrow. That night, not only did Rick and Harold hit it off, Top had news. Harold was going to be a big brother. She was pregnant with Rick's child, the one who would come to be known as Magda Angelique Jones Dubrow. During During the months she was pregnant, Angel Top suffered from a series of nightmares, graphic, disturbing, and gory in nature, more realistic than any dreams she had ever had before. For weeks, she was at the mercy of her own brain, to the point where Susan arranged to take Angel Top to see a hypnotist in Dallas, Texas, a man who was a reformed old associate of her father, Flat Top, Henry Silva, known as Influence in the Underworld, the man who would come to play himself in the 1990 Dick Tracy movie in this timeline. Silva's task was laid out for him, and he knew what to do. The images, while she was awake, were hazy, so while under hypnotic suggestion, he guided her through the images. The farthest they went back was the nightmare where the ship was on fire. This held an anomaly that Silva was able to close in on. Through suggestion, Angelica was able to see a blurry image that wasn't supposed to be there. Silva was able to help her clarify it, but what she saw was unbelievable. She saw a mouth in a young girl's hand, sucking away at a veil of darkness. The face was still blurry, but when she awoke, Influence unlocked her maximum artistic potential for one moment and instructed her to sketch the girl she saw. At first glance of this photo-quality-like drawing, Angel Top swore that it was Esther in Pan garb, since that side of the family has always been obsessed with Peter Pan. In the meantime, Silva cast a hypnotic barrier that would keep out the nightmares, which would eventually wither away on their own. A year following this, Magda, Serena, and Nicole would be born within months of each other. Rick was now a police detective under Robert Jones's command, and Angelica resumed ownership of the chain of wig and beautician salons she had started before the time shift, even personally getting involved as a beautician in the flagship salon that she relocated to Remington Springs. Supposedly, in the OG timeline, Flat Top's eldest brother, striking resemblance to him rather than Blow Top, appeared in Tracy City to give a lecture on the occult, which led to him being invited to a seance done by a New Age girl named Crystal Plenty in order to debunk it. The canonicity of what happened next is up for debate, but Flat Top's spirit appeared to have taken his brother over, creating a few continuity errors in the process. Flat Top, now in Chop Top's body, dyed his hair dark and went on a revenge spree until Chop Top's heartburn sent Flat Top into believing he was having a cardiac episode, prompting him to vanish and Chop Top to regain control. Chop Top was in dismay of what he had done and was now facing charges that Tracy would help him get a plea deal worked out of if he pled insanity. In the Jones sisters' timeline, the only thing that was affected was the seance that never took place. The rest of it was already destined to happen, in the form of a young beauty by the name of Madalena Faye Ariana Saul, or as she was known on Earth, Maddie Jennings, a former nursing student at the university where Samuel taught. She found herself interested in the class he was teaching, since she herself was the embodiment of the supernatural. Maddie was attracted to the single, unmarried professor, and he seemed to find her attractive as well. But being a man of honor, he did not allow himself to think along those lines, focusing only on helping Maddie learn the curriculum, which she excelled at quite well on her own. The last day of class, she gave the professor a phone number and asked that they have at least one date. This one date snowballed into a whirlwind courtship where Maddie was proposed to by Sharp Top, the very thing she had hoped for. The final test was to reveal who she was to Sam, a half-human, fairy-winged princess with pointy ears and leaf hair. Needless to say, they tied the knot. In the present day, when Nicole had her Sweet 16 in the Neverscape, Angelica was one of the humans in attendance. The theme of it was a costume party dedicated to both Star Trek and Batman the Animated Series. Dressed as a Julie Newmar-ish Catwoman, she pulled Nicole aside to the outer terrace of one of the castle's upper levels. It was here she revealed to Nicole that she knew the truth, that Nicole was the one who saved her from herself, her and Rick both. Both. 7 years prior to this, Angelica had met up with Ariella and Esther at Cafe Saucy in Remington Springs with the sketch she had drawn while in Texas. Ariella recognized it right away as her baby sister because of the Titania's kiss mark on her face. Nicole didn't feel that she needed to say anything, that the peck on the cheek from her godmother said it all.
A few months later, in that same castle, Magda would be told the truth about the altered timeline they occupied, when a game of Peter Pan had gone awry, of which Magda played one of the lost boys. Real pirates escaped from the Neverscape gulag and kidnapped most of Team Pan Fan. Magda was exhibiting unusual powers of telepathy and magic, being able to summon the Nevertomes with a substitute pan flute which she had manifested on the spot. These were things that no mere mortal could accomplish. With Maddie and Aurora's help, Angelica, Rick, and Hightop were summoned to the Neverscape, and Nicole explained to Magda their family sorted past in the OG timeline. It was then that Magda was ascended as a Knight of Pan, Aurora revealing that Magda's birth was magic all its own, and that Nicole's aura had also affected Magda in the same way. And with that, we come to the end of the special Nevertomes presentation. Thank you again for watching. Remember to like and subscribe to my video, and be sure to visit my blog site, www.jonesisterscomic.com. For all of you who watch these videos, I give you a special shout-out and my thanks. Tune in next time to learn more about the far-stretching roots of the family tree of Petra Pan.
Transform and fly out!